Hi, Steve and everyone. Are you looking for a great album to listen to? If so, I highly suggest the latest album from Meghan Trainor called Taking It Back. This album contains 16 great songs, and something I really like about it is they give me the feel of her first two albums, called The Title and Thank You. This album contains four great collaborations with artists like Teddy Swims and Scott Hoying, who you know from Pentatonix. I enjoy all these songs, but if I had to pick one, I'd probably have to pick Dance About It, which is the 14th song on the album. It's a very fun song, and it gives you a lot of great feel good vibes, so I appreciate that. Other songs I like on this album are Taking It Back, Bad For Me, Breezy, and Drama Queen. But I like all the songs. I think they're all good. You can get this album on your favorite streaming platforms like Apple Music and Spotify, and also online in stores and CD and vinyl formats. I really hope you enjoy this album.
If you haven't heard, this is Steve Zynels, and we're going to be talking about Meghan Trainor's new album called Take It Back. And you can get this exclusively at Target. I love all her songs on here. Her songs are called Sensitive, Made You Look, Take It Back, Don't Make It Look Easy, Shook, Bad For Me, Superwoman, Rainbow, Breezy, Mama Wanna Mambo, Drama Queen, While You Were Young, Lucky, Dance About It, and Final Breath. And I love it. I'm glad she went back to the pop sound, the bebop sound, like her original sound. It's one of her best albums in a long time. This is Meghan Trainor, I think. I don't know if I said the name. And that song I just played was Made You Look. All these songs on this album is fantastic. I suggest you go listen to it. And it's worth the money that you pay for it. Whether you get a vinyl, or whether you get on CD, it's awesome. I love how the album is holographic. It's just one of her best, and I've listened to it over and over again. I suggest you go listen to it. So yeah. Next, we're going to talk about Manifest. I'm glad Manifest is back on Netflix. It just came back last Friday. I love how they answering all these questions that they left us with 2.5 years ago about where the plane went for 5 years, if Eden is alive, because I forget the girl's name, she that took her, and there's to answer all these questions. Ben finally saves his daughter, and we get to see Cal, is finally the same age as his sister Olive. I'm just glad that they bring it back. And that they're answering all these questions. I don't want to give it too much away, but if you want to watch that show, it's on Netflix, so you can start at the beginning. And this is part one of season four, and there's gonna be two parts. I think the next one comes out sometime next year. So if you want to go see it, that's on Netflix. It's really good. I'm glad, and like I said, it's a good show. Sad to see that it's ending, but I'm glad it's got an ending on Netflix. So that's Manifest. Next, we're going to talk about Titans, and that came back last week also on Thursday. It's kind of cool to see that they bring Lex Luthor, but it's sad to see the spoiler, they killed him off. And it's kind of cool to see Connor interact with his one of his biological creator dads, Lex, and because I'll call it a clone of Superman and Lex Luthor. Their genes is created like in a lab, so his genes are put together, and I don't know who this character is, but he like makes people bleed from the eyes, so kind of cool to see what they're gonna do with that character and see what they're gonna do with all these characters, see how Raven, how she's her powers are progressing, and I just I'm glad that it's back, and that comes out every Thursday on HBO Max. It's cool to see these characters develop, see Superboy develop into a stronger, powerful character, and to see the next step in that show. So if you want to watch that, it's on HBO Max. Next topic we're going to talk about is Quantum Leap. We saw him, he was this week, this past week, he leapt into like young adults who escaped from this, it's a school that they're trying, for people that like their parents send them there for they have some problems and they escape, and he's trying to help them not die, because in the original timeline, they're going to die just from starvation, and it's cool to see how he helps them, and you finally find out why he did the Quantum Leap program at the beginning. It's to save his fiance. Spoilers. And I can't wait to see what they do with that. We have to wait until January 2nd. That's when it comes back. It's pretty cool to see how he helps all these people. And it's a good show, and that comes out every Monday nights it comes out. So if you want to watch that, it's on NBC. So it's as if this is the first season of being back. Next show I'm going to talk about is Mighty Ducks. That comes out every Wednesday on Disney Plus. It's cool to see how the Mighty Ducks this week. They went to the Honda Center where the Mighty Ducks, or not the Mighty Ducks, where the Anaheim Ducks play. I don't know if you know this fact. Did you know that the Mighty Ducks, well, now they're Anaheim Ducks. Did you know that they're actually based off the film The Mighty Ducks? That's they were inspired by that, and they went there for some inspiration because they're not. They're not the strongest of teams in this tournament and Epic, so it's kind of cool to see what they're going to do with that, and hopefully they win the whole tournament. It's cool to see Evan become the captain of Dominance. I don't want to give the whole thing away, but that's on Disney Plus if you want to watch that show. It comes out every Wednesday, and it's cool to see what they're doing with that. Next but not least, we're going to talk about We're going to talk about the NFL picks for this week. I'm going to find I'm going to find what my friend Billy says.
Who he's picking.
So this is Steve and Bill's picks. It's usually Steve, Bill's, and Joe's picks, but I couldn't get in touch with Joe. So the first game is on Thursday night. It's Atlanta Falcons versus Carolina Panthers. Bill says that the Falcons will win 28-17, and I agree. I think that the Falcons are just way better than the Panthers. The Panthers, they're horrible this year. They're worse than they were last year. So I just think the Falcons are a way stronger team. I think they'll win 31-17. So a little bit what Bill said. So I just think the Falcons are way better. They're a mediocre team. And I can't believe if they win, they'll be in first place. Sole possession right now, first place in the NFC South. So I just think they're going to win that game. The next game is the Seattle Seahawks versus Tampa Bay, and I'm surprised that Seattle's better than Tampa Bay right now at this point in the season. Tom Brady, it just seems that he's not himself. He's not what he used to be. He's showing his age. So I think I'm just surprised Seattle's as good as they are. I believe they're in first place, and I think that this might be a back and forth game because they're both mediocre. But I think Seattle will win this game. I think they win by a touchdown. I think they win 34-27 against the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. And Billy says that Seattle will win 27-24. The next game is Minnesota Vikings versus the Buffalo Bills. Billy wrote about says the Buffalo Bills will win 38-30. These teams are both good. I agree that Buffalo is going to win. I just think it depends if Josh Allen plays. Hopefully he plays because he's my fantasy football team. If Josh Allen plays, it's going to be, I think, a two-score game where the Bills win 42-31.
31. But if not, it's going to be, it might be closer. So depends to see if Case Keenum plays. But I do think the Bills will win this game over the Minnesota Vikings. The next game is the Detroit Lions versus the Chicago Bears. I think the Bears are better than the Lions. The Lions have been in the all games they've been played. They play, but they're just not that good of a team at this moment. So I think the Bears, I think they win by a touchdown. I agree with Billy. He says Chicago Bears 27 and Lions 20. I think that's what will happen. I think the Bears will win this game 27-20. The next game is the Jaguars, Jacksonville Jaguars versus the Kansas City Chiefs. The Jaguars are an okay low team, but I just think the Kansas City have way too many weapons. I think that this is a blowout. I think they win 42-17 against the Jaguars, and Billy says the Kansas City wins 36-20 against the Jaguars. The next game is the Houston Texans versus the New York Giants. Billy says New York Giants win 28-24, and I'm just gonna say, even though the Texans are not a good, they play back and forth with the Eagles. I just think I'm gonna pick the upset. I'm gonna say Houston wins this game in a close game. I say they win last second on a field goal. I say they win 24-21 against the Giants, an upset. I just think. I'm just going to say they're going to upset them this week. The next game is the New Orleans Saints against the Pittsburgh Steelers. Billy says Pittsburgh's going to win 23-20. I think the Pittsburgh will upset New Orleans. I think they're going to win. I agree with the score. I think they're going to win 23-20 against the New Orleans Saints. Both these teams are not that great. So I just think Pittsburgh will upset the Saints this week. The next game is the Denver Broncos versus the Tennessee Titans. I just think Tennessee is way better than Broncos. Russell Wilson's not playing well. They have no weapons there in Denver. So the Titans just have a way better team. So I think the Titans win. I think they win by 42-24. And Billy says 34, Tennessee, Broncos 24. The next game is the Indianapolis Colts versus Las Vegas Raiders. Billy says Indianapolis wins 21-18. I think it'll be a close game. This is Jeff Saturday's first game as interim coach. And I don't know. We'll see what he does, but I just think the Raiders win this game because Josh McDaniels has more experience as a coach. And I think that it's a close game because both these teams are not that great. So I think it'll be maybe like 21-7. The Raiders win against the Colts. The next game is the Dallas Cowgirls versus the Green Bay Packers. And Aaron Rodgers just looks lost this year. There's no weapons. He doesn't have any weapons to throw to. The defense is not great. And I hate to say this, but I think Dallas wins this game. I think they win it easily. I think they win 35-14 against the Packers. Hopefully that doesn't happen, but hopefully Rodgers wakes up and wins, but I just think Dallas is a way better team right now than the Packers. And Billy says that the Cowboys will win 27-17 against the Packers. The next game is the Arizona Cardinals versus the LA Rams. Billy says that the Cardinals will win 26-24. I do think it'll be a close game, but I don't think the Rams lose back-to-back games. They are the Super Bowl champs for a reason, even though they're not that good this year. So I think the Rams will win this game. I think it's opposite. I think the Rams win 26-24. The next game is the LA Chargers versus the San Francisco 49ers. I think the 49ers are better than the Chargers. I think that the 49ers will win this game. I think they'll win in a two-score game. I think they win 38-24 against the Chargers. And Billy says the Chargers win 34-30 against the 49ers. The next and last final game is the Washington Commanders versus the Philadelphia Eagles. Billy says the Eagles win 34-20. I think the Eagles win. I think it'll be a blowout. I think they win 42-17. The Eagles just have a lot more weapons than Washington. They have way better defense than Washington, so they can put pressure on Taylor Heineke. They can pick him off. And they can run the ball. They can throw the ball. I just think they're way better than Washington. So they win this game against the Washington Commanders this week. The Eagles win. So I hope all your teams win besides the Commanders, besides the Cowgirls, besides the Giants, besides the Patriots. I hope all your teams win besides those teams. And you have a good NFL Sunday. Before I get off this episode, I would like to congratulate the Phillies for a good season. They were robbed of a world championship. And hope they come back next year and they go far in the playoffs and go to the World Series and they're not cheated out and they win the World Series next year. But good job, boys. We weren't expected to be in the World Series. I'm proud of you. I'm proud that you are the National League champions. And what a good season it was. And keep dancing on your own. And next year, if we get the right pieces, hopefully we win the World Championship, the World Series. Thanks for the memories, boys. It was a good World Series, even though we were cheated. You are the true champions. So thanks for watching my show. Please subscribe on YouTube at the Steve Ball Show. And thank you for watching, and please subscribe. And have a good week. Thank you.